Every day we receive thousands of terrible VHS tapes and DVDs. Some are so fucking weird we don't exactly know what to do with them. That's why the Wheel of the Worst was designed. It's a torture device for the modern age. The wheel is spun 3 times. Each spin selects a video at random for the group to watch, and then evaluate which video is the best of the worst. It's now time to spin the Wheel of the Worst!
Oh! Hi! It's our friends from Canada, Jim and Colin.
Hi, Mike.
Hi! Well, guys, welcome back. Let's spend our valuable time together watching terrible, terrible VHS tapes.
That sounds great.
It's just like every other time we come down.
It is.
Our first tape on the Wheel of the Worst today is called Come and Learn the Alphabet with Ms. Utterly. Service mark. That's wrong.
What does that mean?
Well, a trademark is like is a trade.
Something's successful?
No. A trademark is like something that you sell, a product. SM is less frequent. It's called a service mark. So, meaning, if you want to grab a puppet of a cow and start teaching the kids the alphabet, she can sue the fuck out of you.
What? Possible she had it trademarked, but maybe Miss Utterly doesn't know the alphabet very well.
Oh. I have nothing else to say about this. Jim?
Next film is Message with Siri.
I believe that says Massage.
Oh. Massage with Siri. I see some hands and someone standing up against a wall with a blanket. That's interesting.
Siri, can you give me a massage?
Okay, Colin, here is what I found.
Oh my God. I was giving him a massage. Siri is. I thought you were just making some kind of joke.
No, why would I do that?
Because of the videotape.
Because of the title of the videotape. Our next film, Colin, if we can interrupt your massage.
Sorry.
Is this.
Kid Escape from Child Abductors. Help your children and students learn how to stop kidnappers when they can't run, shoot.
Oh, God. When they can't shoot back. When your kids are unarmed for that.
Kid Escape! It's from Kid Escape. That's a great picture, by the way.
Yeah.
It's funny, like, you guys always joke how, like, the 80s and 90s, people would pretty much, like, put out VHS tapes of, you know, anything. I'm surprised they don't have, like, how to abduct kids.
Ouch! Warning! Selling errors are hazardous to your wealth. Twelve minutes in length, that's all we need to know.
This isn't to say we've trained 2,000 salespeople on action selling, and it's a quote by the 3M company who made the material for the Star Wars lightsabers. 3M material.
They make tape.
So I hope this is kind of like Star Wars.
I think it very well could be. Colin, what's our next VHS cassette tape?
Wormania! Live Worms and Song, starring Billy B, who looks like an asshole, Mary Applehoff, and the Brennan Kids.
Mm.
This looks right off the bat, like without the title, I'm getting like a real bad, like kind of Christian band vibe from them.
Geez.
It's like she looks like she's about to lay down some sick
some sick beats about
spit
Christ.
Spit some hot fire about Jesus.
Yeah.
It says live worms and song.
Yeah.
So does that mean there's actually live worms?
No, that's the children, the Brendan kids.
Oh, okay.
Because you can't look that up online.
Slip in a Christian message somehow. It's just going to slip a worm in your drink. I don't know what that means. Clearly, this lady is a loser. Maybe the biggest loser ever. I mean, and I'm sure that lady has become worm food. Ironically, I should have saved that joke for the discussion. If we watch this, I'm done. Whose turn is it now to talk about this film, which...
I think it's mine.
It's your turn.
Danger Zone!
Is this a documentary about Kenny Loggins?
It's on the front.
Velcro.
Velcro. God damn it.
Oh, there we go.
Hey. Wait. Yeah, see?
What's it pulled out?
Danger, someone had
pedestrian
no idea what they were doing.
Video. It's a forklift.
Right. Oh.
Yeah, it's coming right at
pedestrian
us.
Pedestrian safety. So we know nothing about its length or its content other than pedestrian safety video.
And cities full of forklifts.
Oh my God. Jim, you're next.
No, that's just a danger zone.
I thought
me,
I did
unfortunately.
That.
Unfortunately, magic well, tricks you can do by magician Doug Anderson. Also looks like an asshole. And this is a really special tape because it's actually signed by Doug Anderson. And it says here, I don't know if you can see that in close up, but it says all, A-W-L, D, best.
Oh, all the best.
D is for, I guess, Doug.
Yeah.
Why would he spell all that way? Like the tool way.
Yeah, all the best. Maybe it's his Texan.
It's like his draw.
No, but that's what all magicians say. Like once they do the trick, it's like all the best.
Did they?
Is that a thing?
Like pulling rabbit out of a hat. All the best.
I think you're making this up.
I'm not.
Well, he already did one magic trick. He can make his audience disappear. I certainly hope he's dead. I hope he's disappeared. I hope he's done a trick where he's turned himself into a skeleton. He made all of his flesh and organs vanish.
The D's for Doug, right?
Yeah.
It's not, so. It could be for Dew.
Yeah, that's a good one. What do you think? Is all the best?
All do best.
All do best.
All do best.
All do best.
My twin, dolls matching outfits and fun accessories, the one-of-a-kind doll personalized to traumatize your child. Sorry, personalized to look like your child. 3 7-minute video, so that must be inside the video. Call 1-800 for a free catalog. This video may be copied for friends.
Oh, sweet. Oh.
Yeah. And on the site it says, my twin, dolls, matching outfits, and fun accessories.
It's pretty creepy. So I think, is this like a backup child in case yours dies?
I mean, they're not exactly twins, like massive head, smaller head.
Well, the doll doesn't have that fucked up grill.
Wait, that's not the doll?
No, it's a child with encephalitis.
It looks like it's a child taxidermy video. She's got the doll. She has more lifeless eyes than the doll.
It's now time to spin the wheel of the worst. Give it a spin, Jim. Oh my God. Oh no. It's my twin. I'm so excited. Let's go watch My Twin. All right, Colin, it's time to spin the wheel. That video sure was great. Uh-huh.
Dear my twin, thought you might like this group picture of my three girls and my sister's three girls.
They have no sense of individuality.
On all of our outings and
Everyone takes notice.
Creepy.
Imagine them saying, that doll looks just like your daughter.
Oh.
The staff at the doctor's
creepy.
Office saw the twin.
And while we've created thousands of unique individual My Twin dolls, it's safe to say no two have ever been the same.
How many times did somebody get sent the wrong doll?
And then develop self-esteem issues, body image issues.
I'm not Puerto Rican.
Well, it's 7 minutes later. Colin, let's spin the wheel again.
All right, let's do it.
Tricks you can do.
All the best.
All the best.
Oh no.
Oh yeah.
Hi, welcome to the wonderful world of magic.
God, put on your hat.
He looked way cooler on the box.
Some really cool tricks that you can do with simple props you find around the home, the office.
Does he have Darth Maul horns? What is on his head?
The first trick involves the use of a half dollar. Watch the coin very carefully. It's gone. How does the trick work? It's simple. It is up my sleeve. Is that cool or what?
I didn't see it. As the graphic came up.
Oh no.
Oh no. How long is this?
Was that a take?
It's already too long.
Right up the sleeve.
We need close-ups of your hands.
When you're practicing this trick,
you need a second angle.
Make sure there's no glass or china shops behind you.
And just there's nobody behind the camera, that's why.
That's
like,
yeah.
He just set
point.
It up on his own.
Yep, he filmed this in his basement.
Well. His parents' basement.
Hey, Rich.
Hey, guys. I guess we've been tricked. I'm gonna spin the wheel. Oh, fuck my ass.
At least we'll learn the alphabet.
Mr. Oven Mitt.
These are letters.
Wow.
A special book? What?
I guess because they're flying out, it's special.
Songs by John Dark.
So it's like an SNL skit.
Special book? Let's have the next letter. Here is D, and E, and the letter
F. Kaz being very patient.
Show them to you.
Was it really good at the end? Like, was the quality of the movie?
Oh, no.
No,
we're talking about the prequels, right? Because it sucked.
It was the last saying,
No, those delivered. Those movies were delivered on time.
That's the important thing.
I suppose.
Yes, yeah.
You gotta make those dates.
Yeah.
Well, this episode was a shit show, and you guys are gonna talk about it now. Our first tape is My Twin, with two N's. Mm. Here you go, Jim.
All right, My Twin is some corporation that makes a twin of your child as a plaything. They manufacture...
In an innocent way.
That's your mind.
Who can explain the mystique, the magic of little girls and their dolls? Their playmates, confidants, and best friends. They play a valuable role in developing self-esteem, imagination, and social skills.
The corporation sells dolls that look like your children. So you send in photographs to the company, and they base the skin tone, the hair color, the eye color on your child, and then they make clothes for the doll and then larger clothes for your child. And I don't know.
What's the purpose?
The child can dress up like an object that you
The child is yeah. to turn
Well, dress up like an child. Object and learn to become completely obsessed with themselves.
Right. Yes. Yeah. Yes.
The point, yeah, to make your child a
I mean, just look at that girl on the front. Like, she looks like a smug little asshole, right?
Yeah.
Like,
yeah.
Look at her cold dead eyes. I think she grew up to be the woman in the alphabet video.
Oh
is this
God.
Like a horror movie? Like, does the doll slowly sluck away? Is this like a horror movie? Does the doll slowly just suck away your soul? It like leeches your humanity away from you and eventually the child becomes like the doll?
Well, this was, it was the video slowly sucked away our souls and we weren't even, you know, exposed to the dolls themselves.
Fortunately, it was only 7 minutes long, so.
Great attention to detail with the dolls though. They actually like, in one scene they show them marking pencil marks for where like the kid's freckles are.
Yeah, and then they show the actual doll getting the freckles put on and it looked like the Chucky doll. It looked creepy.
But I mean the attention to detail is great. Like they don't look exactly like the kids, but you know. If he had bad eyesight, they'd look identical.
Do they start with this like sort of like a generic doll like head or something like that?
I can imagine they got like four or five.
Yeah,
they got four or five generic heads.
Yeah,
they slap some paint on it.
Yeah. Yeah, yeah. They showed their palette of like skin tones.
Yeah, the generic
and there's not
eight
a whole
skin
lot.
Tones in
yeah.
the world.
But they showed there was like a clip of like the mom holding up the skin tones to the kid's face. Like kind of picking the one. Like.
The special magic of a My Twin doll begins with...
Is this what drove that woman who had 50 operations to look like Barbie insane?
Yeah, probably.
I'm picturing like this seems like the type of thing that a parent would get more obsessed with than the kid. Where the mom's like, get in here, Sally. I've got to match your skin tone. And the little girl's like, Mom, I just want to go outside and play soccer.
Well, not the kids in this video, because they looked like they loved their little twin dolls.
Well, they were all on drugs. Really,
yeah, that's true.
For some reason, there was like a third doll.
Our cuddly sisters and cuddly brothers have adorable lifelike features.
Finally, some equality.
Oh, God.
There was a smaller doll, so even like the twin...
Oh, the doll had a doll.
The twin had a twin.
The twin had a twin, yeah. So you have the normal human, you have the twin, and then you have the twin's twin.
Did they mention that as a selling point, that you can have this too? Because I don't remember that part. They just started
they
appearing
glossed over
with
it.
Like
They glossed over everything, because they show other products. Like there's little puppies.
If you like our dolls, you'll love My Twin Posable.
How many products do you have?
Child-sized, doll-sized, and...
But the dogs aren't twins.
They're like...
Right?
Right down to their...
They've gone off the rails to products.
They've lost focus of their brand.
A human puppy hybrid twin.
Really half-assed on those puppies. Because they all look just like generic...
Well, they blew all their money on the skin tones of the twins.
Right.
You know,
they probably got like 20 skin tones, probably five different heads.
Yeah,
and...
but look at this one. This is like that doesn't look like a generic head. That looks
That's
very
the Connie
specific.
Chung doll.
Yeah,
this is some like fairly mass producible customization. Like
right,
you get a few options.
Yeah,
and they can charge you like $250 for the doll.
I get the feeling it's probably really expensive because it doesn't, it's not assembly line. They show them all like punching in all the eyelashes.
They show all the slave labor, like kind of like, you know, drawing all the hand painted eyebrows and like, you know, freckles and stuff like this.
And the sign in the background behind someone who's painting the skin tone that says, please no talking. And I like to socialize with each other.
You have twin dolls to make.
And they have, place to
they
work.
They have suicide nets outside of the windows so the workers don't jump out.
It's like the Wonka factory. You work there and horrible things happen to you.
Maybe a German kid gets sucked up into the chocolate pipe.
Little Sally fell into the skin tone vat.
Now I want to see a whole movie about the tour of the My Twins factory.
What if it was just like kids?
She used to be African, now she looks Irish. Wait.
No, it's like they actually just get like real kids and like dip them in this like embalming fluid and like.
Oh, that's how they make the dolls.
It's like, oh, it's so lifelike.
They're actual children underneath the plastic.
Yeah, it's like we need more Asian kids.
It's Phantasm 4.
You have one of these My Twins for a couple years, and the little girl's like, "Mommy, my doll's starting to smell."
It's like slowly the intestine starts sluicing out of the plastic jelly.
Oh, God. Is this how Body World started? They just started buying up all my twin dolls.
No, Body World. It started. They wanted to make toys for children. They wanted to make these dolls. It wasn't. They didn't look realistic enough, so they started just embalming small children. And they realized over time that you would see their insides, and it morphed into Body Worlds.
Oh, it's so rotten.
My twin posable puppies are the most lifelike and posable flesh. Plush.
No, you're thinking of the real life dolls. What are those called?
Real dolls.
Real dolls? Yeah. You're thinking of real dolls.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. Yeah. We were joking this company actually eventually evolved into like the real doll.
Right.
They realized all their orders were coming from perverts. So they decided to change it to real dolls instead of this bullshit aimed at children.
Oh god. So so can we talk about what exactly is the purpose of these dolls?
A My Twin doll is the perfect way to capture the uniqueness of your child at her precious age. It is a gift of imagination, a gift of self-esteem, and a gift that provides treasured memories for a lifetime.
You have to teach your daughters early that they're just an object that other people can do what they want with. Is that what I look like? Did anybody get their twin doll and that was what they said? Like, it was like a manufacturing defect?
Mommy,
like,
I'm sorry, I'm such an embarrassment. One of the eyes was just weird.
Well, we were talking about, what do you do if your kid has some sort of birth defect? Like, what if the elephant man wants a My Twin? What do you do?
Well, you pay by the pound of, like, Sculpey. That
you
stick. You
gotta pay for extra plastic.
Yeah, yeah. They start with the basic thing, sure. And then it's just like, whatever, you've got three arms or something.
You got a finger growing out of your forehead?
It's fine, no problem.
You just have some poor woman who's just constantly obsessed that her right ear doesn't look weird. It just becomes her obsession in life.
Yeah.
So I don't know how this is gonna benefit children. Like, everyone looked happy in the video, but it's like, this is just gonna give your kid a complex.
Well, of course they look happy in the video. It's a promotional video. What do you think, they're gonna cut the shots of miserable children with their ugly dolls? Yeah.
Or that doll, the hair is ripped out.
It's like they're promoting it. It's like, and they said, it gives your kids self-confidence. No.
Your first decision will be whether to get a posable or a non-posable doll.
Well, the only way a kid could feel better about themselves than they feel about the doll is if the parents skimp and buy the non-posable kind.
Oh yeah, right. Because like, well, they had posable.
Yeah, at least
and
all my limbs work, and this fucking thing just lays there.
But even remember they had the girl with the busted leg.
When the staff at the doctor's office saw the twin, they decided that the twin needed a matching cast also.
Is that covered by your insurance?
Oh yeah.
And then they had the doll with the busted leg, but we were saying like the doll was like broken in the molding process, and they broke the kid's leg just to match.
I paid $400 for this doll and you are going to match.
Could you ask for a larger doll than you? I think it'd be cooler to have like an identical like doll twin that looks like almost like a Hollywood prosthetic that looks exactly like the kid, so that's
even creepier.
No, but that would be great because then the kid could play tricks and it'd be like,
exactly,
you know, mommy, I feel sick, and they put the twin in the bed and then they sneak out the window and go do something else instead of going to school, and then you have like,
that's thinking. It's like, right. You know, it's like I was like,
or they prop the doll up like in the classroom. Like it's in their desk.
Or as a real goof, they hang a noose around the doll and hang it from the rafters. The parents come in, oh, it's hilarious.
And they're made from real dead children, so when the medical examiner comes, like, well, your child is dead.
There's definitely some DNA in here somewhere.
The evidence shows it died months ago, but I don't know.
It appears to be Asian, but that's very weird. Anyway.
Like, your daughter was an Asian, and he just painted skin colors on it. Really weird.
Prison breaks would be very useful. Like, you know, Clint Eastwood's making that paper mache version of himself in Escape from Alcatraz. It's like, you just order one. I want to.
I want to.
Gotta put him in the thing.
Lights out.
You have the sequence in the prison movie where they're smuggling in like the twin doll catalog so they can it's them huddled around looking at this like pink book. Pictures
it's
of
like
dolls.
Smuggled in a cake?
No, it's smuggled. I had to hide this up my ass.
Jeez.
When the guards, they do the search, they find this twin doll book in the cell. It's like, what the fuck?
This book stinks.
Clint, we're trying to match your skin tone. Hold on.
It's got to be like
child labor painting eyebrows on Clint Eastwood dolls.
The lame escape!
Except the doll is like this big. It's just in this tiny little bed.
Well, that's when you stack several of them on top of themselves and put a giant trench coat on.
We're gonna need to change the plan. We now need six dolls.
So it's like, it's literally the premise of a horror movie. It's like these things. This would be a great horror movie.
Yeah.
Like they made what you guys it. It was called The Boy.
I haven't seen it.
It sucked.
Did they get a thing of their child?
Yeah. Their child died, so they got a doll, and they pretended that the doll was the child. And then there's a twist. Spoilers. There's a twist that the child's not dead, and he lives in the walls.
Oh.
What?
It's great. It's great. It's a great movie.
Did you ever see the movie called Hider in the House?
No.
Gary Busey, it's about a family that moves into a house, and Gary Busey lives in the walls.
I thought there was more to that, but I guess that's all you need.
Well, it's like Gary Busey in your walls.
That would be frightening.
Hey, guys, I turned down the air conditioning, and I'm trying to sleep in your walls.
Right now, Gary Busey is sleeping in someone's wall.
That's
so
true. You have to, like, lure him out with Reese's Pieces? You gotta try and get Gary Busey back to his home.
When you open the closet door, he's just sort of hiding in your dolls. He's this guy, he's just got these big chiclet teeth.
He falls out of the closet and he's like, me pee. And he's just covered in urine. He's just covered in urine.
Oh. He's in a motorcycle accident. They had to rebuild his brain from whatever they had. Sawdust.
Jelly beans.
Sawdust and gravel.
Yeah.
A sponge and some peanut butter.
Do you want to move on to the next movie?
Yes.
Okay.
So that was my twin, and the next thing we watched was Magic Tricks You Can Do, also known as Tricks You Can Do, also known as Trick You Can Do.
Trick You Can Do? What?
Wait! He fucked up the title of his own video! Oh my god. Wait, there's a Jesus fish on here.
What? Is this Christian magic? Would that be actual magic?
Well, that explains why it's lame.
I'm going to take this solid wooden pencil and change it into rubber. Ready? Watch. One, two, three. The pencil is now rubber. Watch it bend.
Oh, no!
That was in the Malcolm Jamal Warner video.
It's not really bending. The pencil is still wood.
That's not even a magic trick. Here you go, Colin. You explain. Trick and you.
Jesus, indeed.
With Jesus tricks and you.
Are these like official like Jesus tricks that he did in the old days?
Well, they're approved by Jesus. You know. Like,
this is how Jesus turned the water into wine. you take the water glass, just dump it out behind your table.
One. Ow. Two. Ow.
Now, when you run across the water, you need to secretly have raft shoes on.
Oh, Lord. Well, not...
Now, when you bring Lazarus back from the dead, you just gotta have Lazarus pretend he's dead. You wave your hand around, and he just sits up.
Did Jesus also live in his parents' basement?
Oh, he did. Well,
because
probably.
That's what we gained from this video.
He's a carpenter.
Explain the video, Colin.
Oh, Jesus Christ.
Oh. Jinx.
That was awkward.
I'm going to teach you another way of making a coin disappear. Watch close. I'll take the coin, I place it against my elbow, and watch. It's going to dissolve into my elbow. Ready? Here we go. One. Oops.
Magic tricks you can do. So, by magician Doug Anderson, aka Doug Death Scalp Anderson, because you wouldn't know it from the cover. But holy shit, when you start this video, the guy has the most unfortunate hairline I think we have all ever seen.
He has the most embarrassing bald spots. It forms like a little, it looks like horns.
It's like some post-apocalyptic sort of Mad Max.
It's like the light is glowing, like hot on the top of his head.
Yeah.
And he's got like two little black tendrils of hair like coming towards his forehead. It looks like he was wearing like a hairnet that like a chef would wear or something, but it like caught on fire. It's like two little black caterpillars, like just
sort of. Well, maybe he just started like getting dreadlocks, and then he just, nah, this is not working.
I'm gonna grow them out.
Maybe he had cornrows and it didn't work.
Or yeah, cornrows, not dreadlocks, son of a bitch. I fucked that up. I fuck everything up.
What?
Basically, like, just doing magic trick in his parents' basement, and these tricks are horrible, and...
Did you intentionally say magic trick? Singular.
Did I say?
You did.
Did I?
Because that's the name of the video on the video.
Yeah, it was intentional.
You know, it was just the video's way of letting you down gently. Yeah. It's got the elaborate title, then the less elaborate title, and then the fuck up title.
Yeah, it was kind of giving you all the clues.
The video would have been so much less painful if he hadn't been so affected throughout it all. And mm-hmm. So many, I guess, magician types try to be like just, goofy and yeah. theatrical and...
This time, you're going to pretend to put the coin into your hand. You don't really. You really keep it in your left hand. Watch again. See, I just pretended. This is the way it looks from your side.
Move that finger in position.
This is the saddest man.
And then it floats in the air.
It was like desperation.
Desperation is the key because that,
wacky and all the magic yeah. tricks, and it's all shot in like one lock-off shot.
All right. At any rate, you show the coin, and all you have to do is hold.
Is this going to be one long unbroken
oh,
take?
Oh, that would be horrible.
Is it just going to be this shot for the whole thing?
Yeah. Did he make this himself?
He shot this in his basement.
Take the coin.
Well, no, he did get a second camera.
That's right.
Eventually.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, that came in about like halfway through the video.
He begged his parents enough to buy him a second camera so he could finish his magic trick video.
If you follow this mathematical sequence again, and we'll cut to a close-up here in just a few moments, if you follow this mathematical sequence again, all you have to do is mentally subtract 25
from their total. Almost there.
68.
There you go. Okay.
So it's all the magic tricks are just like all the crappy magic tricks you learn in like grade 3. You know, like, just, you're just calling them out. It's like, okay, yeah. whatever. And it's like, oh, I'll do some math magic tricks. It's like, pick a number.
Yeah.
Like, add 3, subtract 3, or whatever. Subtract your original number. The answer's 3, and it's like, magic.
They should call the video, How to Impress Idiots.
Yeah.
Whatever number you chose, Heather, I now want you to multiply that number by 2.
You can do it. You can do it.
Yay!
Yeah. All right. Now, whatever total you have there, I want you to subtract the original number.
Get to it.
So lame. 5 billion.
Oh, fuck off! It's obvious what you fucking did,
exactly.
Jackass.
Is it 5?
Yeah.
Hey, high five.
All right.
Okay, this is a simple mathematical trick. Whatever number
it's not a trick. It's not a trick when it's blatantly obvious. You dumb fuck.
Fucking 4-year-old's gone, but you just took the same number away. Of course, you had complete control over the number. I realized what you did.
You're just shaking a pencil.
You're shaking a pencil.
The old rubber pencil trick. It's like, really?
You
Which
said
we already learned.
That you learned in grade 3, but.
Yeah.
Who is the audience for this?
I have no idea.
This guy. You know, this guy's like, parents.
You know, but is it like
Mom, look
audience?
What I made.
Is it an audience for kids? Or is it an audience for like
people who are trying
adults?
To get their GED?
Say, is this the cover for a video that's for children?
I don't know. It looks like a
some
bad
asshole, some
Western
smug.
Romance novel.
Yeah,
or something.
Exactly.
Do you think he printed this cover himself? Like, do you think this actual cover came out of his home printer and now we own it?
Well, his parents' printer.
His parents' printer.
Doesn't even look
yeah,
like
he can't afford a printer himself.
Like, even his face, it doesn't even look like him.
That doesn't doesn't look like him, does it?
Is it just a picture of somebody who he thought looked cool?
Maybe.
He Googled cowboy hat.
It's like Sam Elliott from Tombstone.
When you buy picture frames and there's a picture in it, you just put that in your house instead of a family member. It's like he just sees some guy with a cowboy hat.
All right, to do this trick, you need two napkins. One napkin, you have balled up into your hand, and just hold that in your hand without them seeing it. Then you show another napkin. Ramble on some nonsense about doing the illusion of the torn napkin. Don't turn this hand towards them or they'll see the extra napkin.
Comedy magician. He calls himself a comedy magician.
Mm. Oh my God. He makes the laughter disappear. So like halfway through the video, he gets like an assistant.
Yeah.
This woman shows up.
I remove that stack, and then I said, Heather, point to two stacks. Again, her selection included the stack of four aces, so I had to remove the ones she didn't pick. Had Heather chose these two...
Yeah, now the question is, did he make this video just to get this girl to come over to his place?
Yeah, probably.
I'm going to impress her with my magic tricks.
And that's where the video got interesting, because that was just us trying to figure out how he lured this woman into his parents' basement.
Yeah, probably from, like, chloroform.
Heather, I'm going to set the cards down like this, and as I'm setting the cards down like this, I want you to call out loudly and clearly the word stop. Within the next 30 minutes or so.
Stop!
It was either his sister or someone he met at night school that he somehow convinced, I'm a magician, I'm going to be a famous entertainer someday, you want to get in on the ground floor.
You help me with my magic video, I'll help you with your makeup tips video.
Hey, there
they
you go.
They had a deal going.
There you go.
She had a kind of miniaturism quality about her, like just something. Like
yeah, it was like this like, forced perspective. Yeah. It was like she was about
Gandalf,
20 feet
Frodo,
back.
Lord of the Rings.
Yeah, yeah exactly. Yeah, sure. It was very
like
weird.
Exactly.
Yeah, it was like.
Exactly. This video was exactly like Peter Jackson's Lord of the Rings trilogy. You're right.
There's another video out there where his assistant is trying to like de-emphasize his bald spot.
Maybe that's her video. It's yes. Like, I'll come over, yes. Yeah, I'll help yeah, you with yeah. Your magic video, and then we'll make my video where
I try to
sell hairspray.
She seemed like she wanted to be there.
Heather, I want you to pretend you have a pair of dice, and if you would, just roll them down on the mat. Okay. Roll them up. Try not to get them off the edge of the table. Pick them up, roll them again.
Are they rolling fake dice?
Write down those two numbers.
Did they just roll imaginary dice?
I have no idea what's going on.
Is that what happened? I wasn't paying attention.
You were rolling dice! You couldn't buy a fucking pair of dice for your goddamn video?
Well, she doesn't disappear right after that. She really doesn't do anything, and then she just disappears.
Heather, thanks again for coming by, and Heather's got to go now. Say bye, Heather.
Bye.
Bing! And no trick photography is being used.
And he tells us that there was no special effects involved in her disappearing, and I believe him.
Yeah, there's a knife involved in a shovel.
The word camera tricks. Camera tricks.
There was no camera tricks.
That's what he said.
She disappeared, right. And I have no reason to doubt Doug Anderson.
Mm. He hung up garbage bags for a reason.
When you lift up the salt shaker and the napkins together, they'll see that the coin is still there. The salt shaker is underneath the napkin. And all you have to do is, as you bring it to the edge of the table, watch. Drop that salt shaker into your lap. Don't
carefully drop the salt shaker onto your penis.
Vanish a salt shaker full of salt. Not one of those empty ones. You know, I wasn't impressed by that trick until I realized that the salt shaker, it had salt in it when it disappeared.
Yeah, it was pretty good.
Yeah.
That was impressive.
It landed on his penile code.
What? What?
Well, that's how the trick worked, right?
Is penile code?
I didn't say that.
What did you say?
Don't know.
Penile code?
Like penal code?
I didn't say that. It landed on his penile code.
Penile code.
Oh.
Is that the new movie directed by Ron Howard, starring Tom Hanks?
And Gary Busey?
I'm starting a new
movie. Or is that just what he got arrested for last week?
Hey, Ron Hyde, I'm starting a new movie called Penile Code.
Hey, thanks for playing. Bye. Hey, welcome back.
Today. Well, what's weird is he keeps doing, he's like, we'll be right back after this break. Mm-hmm. And then it just cuts to like a textured blue screen. Mm-hmm. And then he's like, and we're back.
Which is all video toaster.
We realized at the very end,
we were joking.
What is that effect called?
Well, okay, so when you got the video toaster, it came with all these like...
What's a video toaster?
Video toaster was like a card you got for your Amiga computer back in the day, and it was the first thing you could do these like wipes and like
special effects.
Desktop video.
Toaster 4000 takes the power away from the network and gives it to the people. With Toaster 4000, we can make television better than the networks, and we don't have to answer to anyone.
Created by Dana Carvey's brother.
That's right. Mm-hmm. Who Garth from Wayne's World was based on.
That's right. Yeah.
And he wears a video toaster shirt.
He wears a New Tech.
Too.
Yeah. From New Tech. And so one of
now
the
you know.
Yes.
One
yes.
of the employees from New Tech was Kiki Stockhammer. She was the spokes female for the company, and they had these wipes, these animated wipes, the Kiki wipes, and she would come out and like, you know, do something. So at the very end of the video, she came out with like a little magic wand and went bing.
Oh my god! Kiki Stockhammer, that was a video toaster wipe.
And then like the video, and it was like, that's a video toaster. I knew that, I had one.
That's great.
I wish you could have magically made this video disappear.
Wait.
It's gone!
Hey!
Thanks, Kiki.
That's the end of the tape. I hope you have enjoyed yourself.
Yes, God.
If you have any problems, feel free to visit a local magic shop and they can certainly help you out. Hey, remember the three golden rules of magic. Practice, practice, practice. Number two.
Speak for yourself. You dumb duck.
You have the camera right there. Just do another tape.
And then we watched a fucking idiot talk about a cow, about the alphabet, Rich.
Oh my god, it's like lamb chop with a cow.
I'm right here, Miss Utterly. Hi. Aren't you excited? Today you're going to begin to learn your alphabet. Yeah, I'm excited, but I'm a little worried too. Worried? About what? I'm worried I won't learn all the letters.
You're a dumb fucking cow. What do you want? What the fuck do you want? It's a shitty children's video called Come and Learn the Alphabet with Mrs. Utterly.
Do you think that's a real name? Ms. Utterly. She's not married.
Nobody would marry that cow.
No bull for this cow.
It doesn't say that, does it?
No, it should though.
Okay.
This is like her attempt to be the new lamb chop. Mm. She thought she was like a talented. Mm. And one day she had the foolish notion that she was going to make the next big children's show called Mrs. Utterly.
Okay, you may begin. That?
She looks like she hates the cow.
Take this.
She hates that cow. It feels like an audition for some sort of children's program.
Well, she can carry a tune, and she wrote the songs.
Can't she, though?
Well, possibly. Barely employable.
A is a letter to learn. A is a letter for me. A is a letter to learn.
A for gorilla.
Gorilla looked really annoyed.
She co-wrote songs with some guy. We can only assume it's her lover.
You think she co-wrote these songs?
She did.
It sounds like she wrote the music
the
and he wrote the lyrics. And
she just constantly had the puppet on her hand and was like talking to it during the consulting of it.
What do you think, Mrs. Utterly?
What, did she forget about the letter Q and someone had to step in? Did she forget about the... Honey, you forgot the letter Q.
It's a fucking alphabet song.
One thing that can be said is she's technically, I don't know technically, but she's a good ventriloquist in the fact that her face doesn't move.
Yes. Oh yeah, she's a quality ventriloquist as far as throwing her voice.
Right.
The problem
in terms
is,
of like stage presence
in terms
and
of the face that she uses,
yeah.
Whenever the cow's talking, she looks like a nut.
Right.
I had a great time with that song, Roseanne.
She was like nervous and scared and crazy.
You can, Mrs. Utterly.
P.
It's just this look of contempt with the cow tongues.
Like as her mind is being taken over.
No, the cow's real, and she's just secretly disgusted with the cow.
I'll try!
That's all I want to look at.
Watching your face.
I do.
This is just her in like the cafeteria of a mental institution.
In a row.
What's her name? Does she have a name in it?
I think so.
Roseanne.
Roseanne.
I don't know if they ever say it in the video, but that's her name.
Trellis with a rose bush behind them.
Yeah, why is she behind a fence? It almost feels like you're leering at her or something, like you're a pervert.
Because she was shopping for garden supplies and she thought, oh, this looks nice.
Yeah. This'll go well with my cow puppet.
This'll go well with my cow puppet, yes. An actual children's show would have changed it up.
Like
you have them going through the alphabet. Yeah. And then you have like a cartoon where a frog jumps around on the alphabet letters.
Sesame Street knows how to do it.
Yeah.
No kid is sitting through this thing.
Special book, will you help us by putting the letters in a different order?
Are we fucking done?
Sounds like special book
is the Necronomicon.
So.
But it opens just so that the skull begins.
This special book was not meant for the world of the living.
I'm like guarantee no child would sit through
this. We're locked to that framing, like the fence and the rose trellis
the
bush.
The framing, and the same. Like, so it's basically A is a ladder to learn. A is a ladder to learn.
Yeah, yeah.
B. Is a letter.
No, no,
learn.
We're not done with A yet. It's like A begins with A.
She kind of looks like a Klingon.
No, she looks like Kim Cattrall from Star Trek VI.
What would a Vulcan's children's show be like?
Are we talking about Valeris?
This is just a puppet. It is not an actual cow. These are the letters which you are required to learn. A, B, C, D. There will be a quiz.
But I don't want to be too mean, but you know, I kind of said this.
It was the makeup,
before,
not her.
But this, the woman in this, the Roseanne woman in this, looks like the devil creature from Legend.
Yeah. She looks every
Tim
time
Tim Curry.
She,
yeah, yeah.
Down here we all know
she
the
turns
alphabet.
The camera and it looks like
down
somebody's
here your cow floats.
It's like to concentrate, like. While she's doing the ventriloquism, one of her eyes seems to like go this way, and the other's just like.
It's like her brain is being possessed, and like the cow is like speaking through her.
She keeps looking at the camera
she's
too.
She's actually not a ventriloquist. She's like got some weird supernatural.
A demon,
medium.
A cow demon is speaking through her.
Some parasite is like locked onto her brain stem.
a demon that's trying to discourage kids from learning the alphabet.
Yeah.
If we sing this repetitive song, the kids will want to kill themselves.
They will become more susceptible to our mind waves.
And then Satan can feast on child souls.
Oh, Ms. Utterly.
We'll brainwash the children into walking into this factory where they'll be dipped in wax and sold to other children as a twin.
So you think they're in cahoots, the My Twins?
I think they're in cahoots with the My Twins.
It's like, what is it? Video.
This is like the...
We'll make this child look like Connie Chung and sell it to a little Asian girl.
This is like some Halloween 3 like,
yeah,
going
exactly.
on. It's like, what is it, the Shamrock Corporation or something?
Silver Shamrock.
Wait a minute.
Silver Shamrock.
Yeah.
Both of them.
Roseanne Lederer is behind the Silver Shamrock Corporation. They were using chunks of Stonehenge, and they were putting it in this video to brainwash children. So they would put on masks and turn their heads into bugs, and then they would dip them in wax and sell them to other children as My Twins.
It's the perfect scam.
Mrs. Utterly is grade A!
It's utterly fantastic!
You get it? I wasn't done with that one.
R.
So now it's time to decide which is the best of the worst. Mike, what's the best video of the worst?
Well, you can't beat a dead kid dipped in wax and sold to look like Connie Chung. So My Twin.
All right, Mike picks My Twin. All right. Jack, what's your favorite?
I'm going to go with the My Twin because I thought it was effective, an effective product. I don't know necessarily if I was a child if I'd want one, but I thought they put a lot of effort and energy into recreating the child. And compared to, I hated this guy. And
all right, special guest Max Landis.
Hmm.
What's your favorite video?
Well,
today?
I think these other ones were pretty terrible. I'm also going to have to go with My Twin, just because that. It's coming like very handy, I think. If I had a child and say it died, I would have a backup. It'd be like a backup. It would be like, you know, you have the Apple Time Machine. If your hard drive gets erased, you could just like back it up. I think that'd be pretty handy. If I want a dog, but I want to like, you know, dog to feed or like take out for a walk, I'd get one of these like little twin dogs.
Yeah.
They're pretty cool. If I wanted like a little Connie Chung baby, I'd buy one. It'd be pretty cool. Also, it was like, it was 7 minutes long, so it's by far, I think, the best. This is my favorite of all of them.
Perfect.
What do you think, Jay?
I guess I'm going to be the splitter here. I don't know if you guys know so much. You may be able, you can tell by our speech patterns, but myself and Rich Evans, who's not here today, we both, English is not our first language.
Hmm.
So I really enjoyed the alphabet video. It was a cavalcade of information, and it helped me out a lot with certain letters like L. And theta. That's a good one. So I'm gonna go ahead and pick that one, but I can see where what you guys are saying with the My Twin video. It certainly had a lot to go by. Point being, fuck that guy, Doug Anderson. Sorry.
Doug Death Scalp Anderson. Oh.
Hasn't Doug Anderson had enough in life? I mean, really? Does he, on top of every other failure, does he also need to lose on Best of the Worst?
Yes, he does. Yes, he does.
That poor man.
I know.
It's magic. Not really.
Happy, happy Halloween. Halloween, Halloween. Happy, happy Halloween. Silver Shamrock. Happy, happy Halloween. Halloween, Halloween. Happy, happy Halloween. Silver Shamrock.